You might ask, who wants to hear me talk? What do I have to say? Regardless of who you are and what you do, you have knowledge and experiences to share. What have you learnt to get to this point in your life? What skills have you picked up that other people might not have? The next step is to go online and search for groups that meet in your area and get in touch. They could be specific speaking groups, business groups, or local community groups. Even if your presentation is only 5 minutes, it's a starting point. Start to develop your skills and your story. Your timing, content, and delivery will all improve. These skills can translate into something you can use during meetings, discussions, or one-to-one chats with your team. Implement debriefing after major events. This could include the completion of a project, a presentation, or a meeting with a client. The debrief should take place in two parts, the hot and cold elements. Hot debrief. This should take place straight after the event. Emotions are encouraged, all opinions are welcome, and all members of the debrief carry equal weight. Seniority is not welcome in this environment. Ask the questions. What were we trying to accomplish? What have we done well or not well? What were the outcomes of our actions? What should we continue to do and what needs changing? Ensure any action points are noted and dealt with. Cold debrief. This should happen 2 to 5 days after the event. Any useful data or information should be brought to the debrief. This meeting is more forensic. The extra reflection time after the event might throw up different opinions. Ask the same questions as above and note any action points. Remember, if debriefing is good enough for sport, medicine, and the armed forces, it's good for business too. Teamwork for performance. Once your team is in place, you need to find the best way to work together and get the most out of each other. In your drive for success, it's easy to slip into a dog-eat-dog mindset. This only gets you so far and is more likely to cause you to crash and burn. Many of today's most prosperous companies are changing the way they do business. They have realized that their employees are not commodities to be worked to the bone and tossed onto the scrap heap, ready to bring in the next batch. Instead, they work with their employees to get the best out of them. Many companies have found that affording their employees a level of autonomy, in other words, the freedom to approach tasks in the manner they think best, dramatically increases team performance. Most importantly of all, they have realized that to get results, they need employees to buy into their purpose. A shared drive is an immensely powerful tool. A shared purpose can make a team forgo personal short-term success in favor of the long-term success of the whole team. In other words, sacrifice yourself for the team.